everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekie and welcome back to the Neo Nails channel. In this video, oh yes, we're doing more Christmas nails. We are, because it's all we have in life. Yeah, it's all we have. We're just looking forward to Christmas. Do you know what though? New Year. Oh, well, it'd be like such a relief, won't it, as well? Thank God 2020 is gone. Be gone, 2020. And hoping that we leave behind COVID-19. What do you think, Amy?
Oh, I don't. I mean, I'm hoping we do, but I think January is going to end up being worse. Well, pay the price in January.
What do you think? Oh no, I don't like it.
Like, doesn't matter what the government says, people are gonna make up their family at Christmas and stuff like that, so.
I know, that's the thing, isn't it? It's like, no matter what they do, they'll be wrong. Somebody will moan. Right, so we're doing Christmas, but we're doing nice pink, sort of rose goldy kind of pinks, nice. Not just your normal reds and greens. So I'm going to use Copper Rose as my base colour. It will be covered with this gorgeous transfer foil, because Jesus Christ, look at that. So this comes from this pack. So you have 8 in there, but look at this, it's so nice. So we're going to do a full nail with it. However, we know foil can be a little bit temperamental. So we want a similar colour in the background, just so it's not massively obvious. So I'm using Copper Rose. And I think we'll get away with just one coat of Copper Rose. Pop that in the lamp. Right, so we're gonna use now the foil glue. Now this is a transfer gel, especially designed for the transfer foil.
If you don't have the foil glue, what's the best kind of adhesive to use?
To be honest, this is the best one. You can sometimes use the sticky layer of the gel polish itself, but you won't get like an even application, so it wouldn't come off perfectly. So especially if you've done a design with it and then you transferred it, it wouldn't really work as good. So
buy the foil glue with your foil.
Yeah, definitely. And it'll last a long time, it really will. It'll last a long time. So let's cut a piece of this. And then we're going to lay it down and we're going to start from the middle. And then from the middle out. I do like to use my finger. You could use a lint-free wipe as well. That works quite good. Just rubbing like a lint-free wipe on top. And it's always the silver side down, yeah? Ooh, look at that. So anywhere that hasn't quite caught it, you can go on with a fresh piece and press it on, snatch it off. So a fresh piece that has, basically hasn't got anything taken off it. So like, I mean, this part's perfect, so we can use that part. Pop your thumb on the other side so you can get a lot of pressure. Always support the nail, especially if this is on a real person. You want to support that nail because there is, you know, a bit of pressure pressing down on that nail. And I think we're pretty much covered. Yeah, that. I mean, that's just gorgeous in itself, isn't it?
That is fancy.
That's a bit fancy pants. So, I'm going to seal this with the Urban Graffiti top coat. This is a top coat that has no sticky layer. It's lovely and shiny. And it's going to seal it. Make sure you cap those edges. So bring that brush down those edges. Just so you kind of shrink wrap that foil onto the nail as well. So the next step, what we're going to do is we're going to do a bow. Or maybe a couple of bows. Depends how brave I am. So this colour is A0718. We'll put that in the description box. It will have like it'll have a fancy name, but I just don't know it. I'm going to use the 01 brush.
That one's First Night.
So we've got that sort of basic bell shape. I want to leave that centre open as well. I think that looks quite cool. Just want to do like the little thing inside the bell that makes the noise. Do you know what? We've done bell videos before and I still don't know what that one is called. What that thing, that thing. The thing inside the bell that makes it make the noise. Right, so while this is wet, now this is important, we're going to sprinkle on clear acrylic powder. And we want the gel polish to kind of like absorb it a little bit. And it'll get rid of the shine. And I think this is what's going to make everything look so nice. It's the fact that it's going to be matte. So I've just sprinkled off the excess. I'm going to check it. Is it all matte or is it getting a shine? And it's starting to shine a little bit, and you need to give it a few seconds because you'll kind of just, you'll tip this off and you'll think it's matte, but then it isn't always matte.
It's a clapper or a uvula.
A what? A clacker or a clapper?
Clapper. Clap your hands.
Clapper. A clapper. It's a clapper.
Or a uvula.
A uvula. That is a weird word.
Can be cold either.
Yeah, that's a weird word. It's a uvula.
Yeah, I think you have one like in the back of your throat or something.
Well, isn't that called a clacker? I thought that was a clacker. That. That in the back of your throat. Sorry, I've just been showing everybody the back of my throat. Right, so we've got the little bell here. What we're going to do now is we're going to give the bell a little bow. We want a nice little bow. So let's do some little ribbons. Right, so again, we're going to do the same thing. I'm doing it in sections because it'd be very difficult to do it all at once. Make sure it's all matte. Once it's all matte, you can go in the lamp. So we've got one little pretty bow with the bell, and we're going to do a little bit with white as well now. So let's do another bow here. Right, let's sprinkle, let it snow on top of the bell. It's not quite all matte, so we just need a little bit more. Now we can go in the lamp, give it a dust, And then I'm going to do it like a really simple bow because we don't have a lot of room here. Plus, it'll show you how we can do a simpler bow. Just like that. So you're going to lay the product here. And then from the product, you're going to sweep round and round. And I feel like we could actually make this bow a tiny bit bigger. Do like a double bow. Like that. More powder. Let it snow. In the lamp we go. And I feel like I'm just going to put some little dots on this little bow in white. And I'm gonna add the powder again. And cure. And then we're gonna take the pink and we're gonna add some little dots on this one. Just as like little bits of decoration. And then again, powder. Bury the nail in the powder.
It's like when you go to the beach and someone like buries you in sand.
Oh yeah.
You know, when we're allowed to go to the beach.
When we're allowed to do things. There we are. Right, that's pretty much done now. So you could do any shape. So you could do Christmas trees, you could do icicles, but I kinda like the bells. I think they look quite cute. Let's have a little zoom each.
Nice. It's nice for people who don't like the like super Christmassy red and gold and trees and Santa and everything.
Because that's me. Because I don't I wouldn't personally wear something really overly Christmassy, to be honest. But that, I would. That would work. That would work with me. Yeah, definitely. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you're all ready for Christmas. I am not. I don't think many people are, but you know. And then you've got, oh, and then you've got the Karens of the internet that are like, yes, did all my Christmas shopping in October. Wow, you know what we think of you? Oh, can't say it. Can't say it, not loud.
Not gonna be helpful. I've done all mine.
Oh, you're kidding me, Emmy! You've done all
it's
yours!
It's not wrapped. It's not wrapped. Oh, it's all just sat in baskets.
No, go away, Karen. I'm going to call you Karen from now on. So, yeah, that'll be me tonight, doing a bit more Christmas shopping. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye!